الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم لك الحمد وإليك المشتكى، سبحانك لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. اللهم لك الحمد في الأولى، ولك الحمد في الآخرة، ولك الحمد حتى ترضى، ولك الحمد بعد الرضا، ولك الحمد ملء السماوات وملء الأرضين وملء ما شئت من شيء بعد. أهل الثناء والمجد أحق ما قال العبد، وكلنا لك عبد. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Dear brothers and sisters, the question, why did Allah create us? Why we are as a human being in this earth? Why did Allah create us in this earth? Alhamdulillah, the answer is very clear. Allah says in Quran, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I didn't create jinn and mankind only to worship me. We know, brothers and sisters, anything has goal in this life. The tree has a goal to give us a fruit. The car has a goal to give us a ride to our destination. So our goal in this life only to worship Allah. But notice here, Allah didn't say, I didn't create jinn and ins only to pray, or only to fast, or only to do hajj. But he said, I created jinn and mankind only to worship me. That means the meaning of worshiping Allah or al-ibadah is wider than just praying or fasting or giving charity or other ibadah. So now the question, what is the real meaning of ibadah? What is the exact meaning of ibadah? So ibadah, let us go to any Arabic dictionary, Arabic language, to know what is the meaning of the verb abada, worship. Abada. Abada in Arabic language means to submit, to obey. So that means ibadah means to submit to Allah, to obey Allah. So I should do ibadah by praying, by submitting to Allah with praying. I should do ibadah by submitting to Allah with fasting, with doing hajj. Also, I have to do ibadah in all aspects of my life. I should do ibadah when I come in to my home and I deal with my wife, and the wife deals with me. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, خيركم خيركم لأهله. The best of you, the best among you are the best to his family. So I should know the rights the rights of my wife on me, and my wife should know her rights on me. And I should fulfill the rights of her, and she should fulfill the rights of me on her. So it is ibadah. And here notice why did Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says khayrukum khayrukum li ahli. Because when I deal with people outside my home, some people want to look nice, look kind. So they want, this is from their desire. Inshallah, they are sincere for the sake of Allah, but sometimes it's just they want to be praised from other people. So for that, they look nice. But inside my home, no one sees me other than Allah. So for sure, I will be sincere for the sake of Allah if I deal nicely with my wife, and she deals kindly with me, and each one of us know the rights of the other one. Then, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كلكم راع وكلكم مسؤول عن رعيته. الرجل راع في بيت أهله ومسؤول عن رعيته والزوجة راعية في بيت زوجها ومسؤولة عن رعيتها. So every one of us is responsible. When he is in his house, he is responsible for his kids to raise them according to Quran and Sunnah, to raise them in Islamic way. And Subhanallah, it is big responsibility. And all families and all husbands and wives know how much it is hard, especially in this country, especially nowadays. So it is ibadah too. And we should know and we should be aware of that. The future of our society or our community or our country is after 20 years or 30 years is depending on how much we are caring about our kids. Our boys will be the fathers of future, and our girls will be the mothers of futures. So it is big responsibility. And then the ibadah continues with us in, as I said, in each minute in our life. Like when we deal with each other in financial dealings, it's ibadah too. And we know the longest verse in Quran is called Surah Ayat al-Mudayana in Surah al-Baqarah. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا تداينتم بدين إلى أجل مسمى فاكتبوه. Oh, you have believed, when you contract a debt for a specific term, write it down and let a scribe write with fairness between you. So financial dealings with each other is ibadah too. And if we know how many problems now between Muslims about this issue, because you know the money is close to heart. And Allah says that in Quran, لحب الخير لشديد. الخير, he means the money. So subhanallah, and if I borrow from my brother even $1 and I didn't return it to him, he will get from my rewards in the day of judgment. And if I read the Quran, the whole Quran 10 times, it will not benefit me in the day of judgment if I didn't return the money to my brother. So it is very important to know that the financial dealings with each other is ibadah. So now we are in the masjid, we are doing ibadah, alhamdulillah, we are listening to the khutbah and we are praying. Then when we come out from the masjid, we are continuing our ibadah. When we go to our job, and our job should be according also to Quran and Sunnah, and we should not do any haram. Then when any money comes into my pocket also, then when we should observe what we are looking for, what we are looking at. Allah says in Quran, إن السمع والبصر والفؤاد كل أولئك كان عنه مسؤولا. O Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, indeed the hearing, the sight, and the heart, about all those will be questioned. So when I come out from the masjid, I should not look at the haram, it's ibadah. I should not touch haram, it's ibadah. I should not walk to haram, it's ibadah. I should not drive to haram, it's ibadah. So you see, ibadah is continuing with me in each minute, because it is my goal in this life. Ibadah is, don't look it as an inert way, just praying or fasting or reading Quran. It covers all fields of my life. Then when I am done from my job, then I come back to my home. Then when I come in and smile with you, my wife, it's ibadah, as I said before. Then when I want to get some entertainment, if it's in halal, it's ibadah too. Then when I am tired, I want to go to sleep. Also, it's ibadah if my intention is for the sake of Allah. Because our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّاتِ. For sure, the deeds are according to your intention. If I go to sleep with my intention, I want to be rested, I want to get up next day for to continue my work in this life. It's ibadah too. Even when couples sleep intimate relationship, it's ibadah, and there is authentic hadith about that. You look how beautiful our religion, how beautiful our Islam, and we should be careful a lot about look at our Islam in the whole picture, not as nowadays many Muslims like they think just like praying, oh I'm going to Hajj, oh I do whatever I want, then I will go to Hajj, Allah will forgive everything for. No, this is not the right way, because al-ibadah is way of life, is way of life. Then, but here I want to be more scientific, so I want to give two criteria for any deed you do in this life. Any deed you do in this life can be ibadah, but there is two criteria for that. The first one, this deed should be according to Quran and Sunnah. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى قل أطيعوا الله وأطيعوا الرسول. Obey Allah and obey Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Second criteria, second thing, it should be, I should be sincere for the sake of Allah. قال الله تعالى قل إنما أمرت أن أعبد الله مخلصا له الدين. قل إنما قل إني أمرت أن أعبد الله مخلصا له الدين. O Prophet Muhammad, indeed I have been commanded to worship Allah sincere to him in religion, ikhlas. So now go wherever you want, do whatever you want, just stick to these two things, then every minute, every deed you are doing ibadah, you are achieving your goal in this life, your balance at the bank of hereafter is increasing in each minute you are doing this ibadah. So let me explain about these two criteria. The first one according to Quran and Sunnah. Like if someone started a bank, a checking bank account with interest, and he wants to get money from interest to donate for masjid, is it accepted? No, even he is sincere, he has good intention. No, it will not be accepted, because it's not according to Quran and Sunnah. He should pay from the halal money. And if someone prays, like he wants to be closer to Allah, oh, let me do three sajda instead of two sajda, also it will not be accepted, because it is not according to Quran and Sunnah. So here, Subhanallah, we remember Hadith sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من يرد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين. من يرد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين. If Allah wants to give you some goodness, he will make you more knowledgeable in religion. So seeking a basic Islamic knowledge is very important. Because even if you are sincere, you have good intention, but you don't follow the Quran and Sunnah, it will be rejected. And think with me like in a logical way. When you work with any company, first you should know the policies of that company. And if you didn't follow that policies, maybe you will be rejected, maybe you will be fired. Even if you love your job, if you love your work, but you didn't follow the policies of this company. For that, we should know and we should seek Islamic knowledge. And I don't know any highest level than seeking, is called talab al-ilm, seeking Islamic knowledge. And I don't want to tell you, oh, go and to Azhar, to Egypt, and just studying Quran. No, if everyone wants to be imam, so who will be a doctor? Who will be engineer? Who will care about each other? If my wife is sick, I should take her to Islam, to Muslim doctor, female doctor. So if every woman wants to be imam, wants to like just to read Islamic knowledge, so that's no way for that. So what I mean, basic Islamic knowledge, which all of us need that. So I suggest like a simple way for that, and I read that. Especially I want to focus on Fardul Ayn, what is called Fardul Ayn, which is mandatory for us to learn. Like what the ulama says, like if someone reaches a property, now he should pray. Now he should learn, like bring a booklet, a book about the prayer, and know and learn the rules of prayer. Yes, it's better to learn before, but at that time he should do that. Then it's Ramadan, so he should fast. So now he can also he should learn the rules of fasting. Then, alhamdulillah, he has he gets older. He has money. He should pay zakah. Okay, he should learn zakah. Then he has more money. He wants to go to Hajj, or he should go to Hajj because at that time it's fard. Now he should learn the rules of Hajj. Then, alhamdulillah, he wants to get married. He should learn the rights of her of his wife and the rules of the Islamic house. And we know if we go inside our families how many problems we have. All of this because ignorance. Yes, because ignorance. And I want to tell myself and everyone, no dangerous enemy to it toward each one of us more than ignorance. The ignorant one harms himself more than his enemy harms him. Yes, for that, just look at the first two lines were revealed to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam when he was in the beginning of the da'wah. اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. Two lines, you have six words in two lines about seeking knowledge, about knowledge. Just اقرأ, read. بسم ربك الذي خلق. خلق الإنسان من علق. اقرأ, the second word, read. اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم. Who taught, the third word, taught, علم. الإنسان ما لم يعلم. ما لم يعلم, who doesn't learn, who doesn't know. This is the fourth word, يعلم. علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق. خلق الإنسان من علق. اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم. قلم, pen. علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. He taught the human being ما لم يعلم. He doesn't know. So six words. So then we see like ignorance in our society. So we should be careful about the Islamic knowledge. It's very important. And we know when someone doesn't seek the right Islamic knowledge, then maybe he will go to extreme way. And we know what happened in Pakistan and what we see in our Islamic world. Because maybe I don't justify for anyone, but maybe some people are sincere, but the problem in their minds, the problem in their knowledge. So for that, especially we are in school, we should feed the Islamic knowledge to our kids. The right Islamic knowledge. It's very important, and it is the highest level in our Islam. And for us also, we should care about our teenager. Maybe they go to online. Now the whole world is like a small town. You don't know where your son is going online. Who is contacting with some people you don't know. So start from yourself and teach your son the right way. So now let me move on to the second criteria, which is al-ikhlas, sincerity. For sure, al-ikhlas it needs one khutbah, but just I give a brief. Al-ikhlas means in Arabic, ikhlas means pure. Like if you have a glass of water, it is pure 100%. If you put some dirt, so for sure it will be impure. And the heart should be 100% for the sake of Allah. قل إني أمرت أن أعبد الله مخلصا له الدين. قل إني أمرت أن أعبد الله مخلصا له الدين. If you put anything in your heart other than Allah, you will not be on ikhlas, and the work will be rejected. We call that shirk. Like if I pray, but I in my side, I want people to look at me. I am praying, mashallah, very good to pray. Or when I pay a donation, I want to. Yes, I am sincere for the sake of Allah, but also I want people to look at me. Oh, mashallah, I am generous. Unfortunately, sincerity is very sensitive area in our Islam. If I am like 5% insincere and 95% sincere, all will be rejected. Like imagine, like if you have a glass of water and you put like just a few drops of ink, the whole glass will be contaminated, and you can't drink it. Also, our world will be rejected if little insincerity. For that, sincerity is very important. And when we are sincere for the sake of Allah, we will overcome our ego. We will overcome all problems between each other, especially who works in Islam, like in Islamic Institute, for the sake of Allah. We know like we have conflict between each other. But when I am sincere for the sake of Allah, I don't worry like if my name is mentioned or not, because Allah knows my name. Allah knows my work. And then we will overcome our conflict, because all of us just we working for haqq, for truth, for the sake of Allah. No problem if they knew me, if they praised me, they didn't praise me, gave me anything, they didn't give me. Allah will reward me. But some who are sincere for the sake of Allah, they are fearing about our sincerity to be shown in front of people. Like I heard like small story, like from people who gather the money, like after we are done from prayer, we donate. So the people who gather that money from the box, they saw like $100 are folded inside $1. Because that one who paid that big amount of money, he didn't want people to see him. So for that, inshallah, it's a true story, I heard it. So he didn't want people to see him. So for that, he did that. So subhanAllah, he is fearing. But on the other side, you will see some people, they come and show off, and they tell people, we built this masjid, we did that. So it's very dangerous. If they are sincere, alhamdulillah, and they are like, they talking about the fadl Allah granted them, okay, alhamdulillah, but it is very difficult, very difficult. So sincerity, it is important in our Islam, and as I said before, it needs one khutbah. Finally, just I want to mention one idea. Yes, we said that the main of our goal in this life is ibadah. But you can talk to some people, some Muslim about that, they say, or like they are like working 10 hours a day. You can go to them and tell them, brother, come to the masjid, come to read Quran. They say, we are doing ibadah, alhamdulillah. So now they should bring evidence about that. If you come to them and tell them, okay, pay some money for our Islamic school, pay some money for masjid, then they refused. That means they are not doing ibadah. They are working for themselves just to get more money. So I can deceive myself or my brothers, but I cannot deceive Allah. So be careful. Don't use ibadah. Don't use like our Islam to cover my desires, to cover my intention for this dunya. So ibadah, yes, it's our goal in our life, but I should show evidence about that. Sincerity and our deeds, my deeds should be according to Quran and Sunnah. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Allahumma ghafir lana wa rahamna wa afina wa afu anna. ربنا اشرح لنا صدورنا ويسر لنا أمورنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم انفعنا بما علمتنا، اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، اللهم زدنا علما إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث، يا حي يا قيوم برحمتك نستغيث. اللهم افتح علينا من فتوحاتك ورحماتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم وكن لكل واحد منا عونا ومعينا يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. اللهم وفرج عن كل واحد كربته يا حي يا قيوم وأنت أعلم بذلك، وهي إن شاء الله ساعة إجابة في يوم الجمعة كما سمعنا من حبيبك المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم فرج عن المسلمين المظلومين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها، وفي الشام وفي العراق وفي كل مكان، وفي ليبيا وفي مصر وفي باكستان وفي أفغانستان يا رب العالمين. وردنا إلى فهم دينك فهما جيدا صحيحا على الكتاب والسنة، على البصيرة، على الهدى يا ذا الجلال والإكرام، مع الإخلاص لوجهك الكريم يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. قوموا إلى صلاتكم.
Also, please make dua for some sick people who have requested. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah, ashhadu anna Muhammadar Rasulullah. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون. نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة، ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون، نزلا من غفور رحيم. الله. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين ولا تستوي الحسنة ولا السيئة ادفع بالتي هي أحسن فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم وما يلقاها إلا الذين صبروا وما يلقاها إلا ذو حظ عظيم الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
السلام عليكم quick announcement as you know we announced last week we have started test transmission for our Islamic radio station here it's tuned at 90.5 FM. Starting inshallah next Jummah, we will start live transmission of the khutbah. So if you are running late, you can already tune into 90.5 and start listening to khutbah even when you are in your car. The range is not too extensive, it's less than half a mile. So it's only going to work when you are nearby the school. It's in test phases inshallah, as soon as we receive a license from FCC, for a 30-mile radius, then you should be able to listen to it, inshallah, in a wide radius. So when you go out, please tune into 90.5 FM, and inshallah, you should be able to listen to the test transmission even today. Assalamu alaikum. Thank you.
I know where to stop.